And the last of the Life Simple 7 is maintaining a healthy blood glucose. So not having a healthy blood glucose in its worst case is something called diabetes. There's type 1 diabetes that affects 10% of the population and is something that is largely not preventable. But then there's type 2 diabetes that affects the vast majority. 90% of people with diabetes have type 2 diabetes. And type 2 diabetes is related to family history, but it's also related to being overweight or obese. It's also related to age. So the combination of family history, overweight and obesity, and advancing age can increase one's likelihood of getting type 2 diabetes. But let me back up a little bit. There's also something called prediabetes, and it's exactly what you would think that is. It's not normal or healthy anymore, but it's not quite diabetes. And a blood test can help figure out whether a person has prediabetes. The great thing about prediabetes, well, let me back up. There's nothing great about prediabetes, but the thing about prediabetes is that it has a treatment that can result in reversing the prediabetes back to a normal blood glucose. And that treatment consists of eating a healthy diet, much like the one I described as the second part of Life Simple 7. Some would describe it maybe a little bit more as a Mediterranean-like diet or the DASH diet of the American Heart Association. It includes being physically active for 150 minutes of moderate to vigorous physical activity, which is what I talked about when I talked about the third element of Life Simple 7, and some health coaching that helps people stay with the healthy eating and stay with the physical activity. And a health coach would be somebody who might either call you or text you and say, "Hey, John, looks like you didn't do your weekend physical activity. That's okay. Get back with it, and you can still achieve the outcomes, the goals that you're trying to achieve." Prediabetes can be treated. It prevents people from going on to get diabetes.